Hello and welcome to Pursuit a Perfect System. My name is Terry Ellis, I'm an audio reviewer, and this is my video coverage for the Munich High-End Show 2019. I'd like to thank my show coverage sponsors. Melco, GIK Acoustics, Tellurium Q. I have created lots of videos as part of a coverage for the high-end show, and you'll find other videos like this in my channel. I hope you enjoy this video. If you do, hit that like button, make sure you've subscribed to the channel, and I'll be seeing you all soon.
Thank you for giving us the opportunity to talk about our product to you fine gentlemen. We're going to do a demonstration about power and how power can influence audio equipment either positively or negatively. And let you listen practically as well. So I'm going to talk a little bit technical over the surface of the problem, but then do an actual A-B demonstration so you can actually experience what happens before and what happens afterwards. Before we begin with that product demonstration, I just want to talk a little bit about the problems that we have on the power line. And this is not something that we've just made up. It's something you can actually Google and read about online. There are two main problems that we have. One is called differential mode noise, and the other is called common mode noise. Now, differential mode noise, let's start with that one first. Differential mode noise is created when electrical products draw power. And if you have a switching power supply, which we encourage to have more of because it's more energy efficient, you have greater disturbance on the power line because it's literally sampling the main sinus wave. So you're getting a whole bunch of distortion coming in. And funnily enough, when you go home today, just do a little experiment. As you walk through the door, count how many things you have plugged into the wall sockets all around your home. Every single one of those, whether it's your refrigerator, or your microwave oven, or your television, or even your audio components, as these draw power, they will create differential mode noise, and that will corrupt the main sinus wave, and it will go in both directions. So that's the first thing that we've got to deal with. We've got to deal with the differential mode noise. The second problem we have is common mode noise. 20, 30 years ago, this would be referred to as radio frequency interference. But we now walk around with these smartphones. My esteemed colleague here will demonstrate such a device, but I'm sure you're quite familiar with it. Please hand me your new device.
I shall hand it to you.
Yes, it's mine. We're going to go into cabaret after this. It's going to be great. Think about how much data you can get on this. All kinds of stuff. You can get video images, you can watch movies, you can send emails, you can get text messages. You can download applications that will tell you things you don't need to know. You can even see how crazy England are being from time to time in their politics with one of these things. But this data doesn't get there by magic. I thought it did, but it doesn't. We are bathed in a sea of common mode noise. Really we are, it's crazy. And this also gets transported into the power line because these cables, they're basically a piece of metal. They're an antenna. So we've also got to deal with this as well. So basically, thank you very much. So basically what we're trying to do at IsoTek is we're trying to take power from the wall. We're trying to clean out all of the garbage, and using our RFI rejecting cables, which are shielded, we stop all of this rubbish getting back in. So it's a kind of a closed loop. So that's basically what we're trying to do. On top of that, we also offer very, very high levels of protection using a multiple array of devices so we don't kill the dynamics within the music. Cheap surge protectors generally use a simple MOV. And when a power amp draws power, it doesn't draw it slowly, it gulps power. When the music is dynamic, it wants to get that power. And these cheap surge protectors clamp in and kill the dynamics. You've probably heard it. I mean, if you haven't, you can go to your local DIY store and do the experiment yourself. So we use a sequential array of VDRs. which in combination are far more powerful, but it allows us to step in, a bit like ABS braking. So that's also how our protection works. So let's start the demonstration, and we are going to start the demo. Well, we have to start somewhere. So we are going to start with an insane high tech. Okay. I might have exaggerated, sorry. But it has got a little green light. So this is where we're going to start. We're also going to be using these black power cables here, yeah? And you are probably familiar with these black power cables. And if you want to have one of these black power cables, which are probably less than a euro, it's very, very simple. You go out, you look around this show, yeah, look at all the fantastic electronics, spend 10,000 euros on that new piece of electronics, and you'll get one free. Does that make any sense? But unfortunately, what tends to happen is we get so excited about that new piece of electronics we just bought, can't wait to try it, we plug it in, we're amazed at the upgrade of our audio system, and this stays in place. And this is like a roadblock to the performance of that piece of equipment. It's like buying a Ferrari and driving it on gravel, yeah? And wondering why it doesn't handle quite as well as you expected. So let's not hold our audio system back. Let's give it a fighting chance. So we're gonna start here. We're gonna play a lovely piece of music, which this fine gentleman selected. And then we will move from here to the Corvus. That's this device here. And we will be using our Premier power cables as well. So we're not going crazy high end, but a really sensible solution at a fair price. This first piece of music we will play is by an artist called Maria Mena. It's a great track. If ever you cover a piece of music, you can't just sing it like it was sung previously. You've got to make it your own. You've got to take it into a different way. And Maria Mena takes a fantastic rock band's track, Kiss, and reinvents it in a beautiful way. So I really hope you like it. It's called I Was Made for Loving You, and I surely do.
Wir spielen das Stück eine Minute ungefähr, dann gehe ich kurz hinter die Anlage und stecke einfach um, so schnell wie möglich, und dann hören wir uns dasselbe Stück nochmal an.
Into the IsoTek Corvus. Yep. Corvus is now powered. We will turn the electronics on. You will notice we've changed nothing, no volume levels or anything like this. And we will replay this track for you.
Tonight.
wondering if it was working. And my hairs are now standing up on my arm. And that didn't happen before. It sounded as if someone was sitting on the music. It sounded dull. It sounded as if it was all caught up in a little tiny cardboard box. And now we have air, we have space, we have a high frequency range. This gentleman at the back there in the brown jacket, you reacted quite well. What's your impression? Yeah?
Was haben Sie gedacht?
Er will wissen, was dein Eindruck war.
Perfekt.
Oh.
Gänsehaut.
Ja?
Ja. Ja.
Danke.
Ja.
Danke schön.
Bitte schön.
That was just the first step, though. It gets better. It really does get better. So let's just talk about what happened within the Corvus and why we're actually hearing more out of these fantastic loudspeakers. Now, Stefan over here, he did a damn good job of designing this loudspeaker, but you can clearly hear his poor loudspeaker couldn't perform correctly because it was given a bad power supply. And this is the crazy thing here, right? You're here because you own an audio system, as do I. And I own my audio system because I love music. I love the record. I love listening to performances. Yeah? And you bought this audio system because you also wanted to get the most out of the recordings you love to listen to. Yeah? But what you should have done was not built the house without any foundations. Yeah? The first thing you should have bought is a power cleaning device to give that equipment the opportunity to perform at its absolute best. It really is that crazy. But we come to it last of all. We get so caught up in these wonderful boxes with knobs and lights and bells and whistles that we forget about the fundamental points, yeah? If you want to go running, buy a pair of good running shoes. If you want to build a house, put some good foundations down. If you want to assemble a really high quality performing audio system, you have to think about the input power. Without power, nothing else will work. And then try and think about the room, try and think about the rack system that it goes on as well. Fantastic rack in the corner over there, by the way. So, what's happening in Corvus? Why are we hearing the performance that we are, the performance improvement that we are? Well, at the beginning, I talked about differential mode noise, yeah? And how when equipment draws power, it corrupts the main sinus wave. Well, all of this stuff here is creating differential mode noise. Now, in this cheap power bar, yeah, long power bar, sockets here, you plug your equipment in, yeah? Now, for power to get to this socket here, it has to go through all of the other sockets. And when you put your equipment here, we're creating differential mode noise. So we have a massive cross-contamination of differential mode noise in a localized area. And that's a big problem for performance. With the Corvus, no two sockets are ever directly connected together. Everything is referencing back in a fully styled configuration to a centralized power cleaning filter network. Yeah? So we stop this cross-contamination of differential mode noise. And that is really, really important. It costs us more time, costs us more money in terms of internal wiring, which is the highest grade of copper we can get. 6 9s oxygen free or ONO continuous cast copper is used within our products. Silver plated with either an air or an FEP dielectric, depending on the price class you go to. So unbelievable high quality internal wiring, but we make sure we never connect directly two sockets together. The clue is in our name, IsoTek, isolation technology, everything kept independent from everything else. And unfortunately, you poor customers, normally when you're looking at a power bar you might consider to buy, you look at the top of it. Yeah? Next time, try and look underneath the top. You will find that 99.9% of power bars have all of their sockets wired together at the end of it. So you're kind of back to square one. Yeah. So we don't do that. So that's Corvus. Where we're going to go to next is a little bit up the IsoTek range to Cygnus. That's this device here. Yeah. And imagine Sigmas is not just one power cleaner. It's actually six power cleaners in one box. Every single output socket's got its own dedicated clean power network. We run two at 16 amps, which gives us 3,680 watts of power. And then the other four run at 10 amps because source components don't need quite so much power. So what we're going to do now, we're going to play you a new piece of music, a little bit more dynamic, with everything connected into Corvus. We will unplug from Corvus, plug into Sigmas, and replay you that music track. So it's an AB again, but we're not going back to zero. We're starting where we left off last time. This next piece of music is by a guy called Boris Blank. And if you've never heard of Boris Blank, he's 50% of the Yellow Partnership.
60. He's the creative part, the creative part of the Flakes Quarter.
You see, and I thought I knew everything, but clearly I don't. No, it's quite right. He's a fantastic architect of digital music landscapes, I would say. So it's a really dynamic track. I really hope you like it. It's off the album Electrified, and of course that's kind of quite well themed for this presentation. So, thank you. Make sure that the power amp goes onto the high output power socket, so the nearest the IEC input.
That was a good call.
I thought I'd remind you just to make sure you're doing it right. Sound staging, far more texture. We're going lower in the bass frequency. We've got better articulation as well in the lower frequencies. So Sigmas, six power cleaners in one box, two high current outputs, that would be where you put your power amps, integrated, maybe a subwoofer, and 4 medium for your source, turntable, CD, music server, etc. We've got over 100,000 amps worth of protection as well. So you have protection, better sounding audio, more enjoyment out of your music. We're now going to move from the Sigmas to Genesis
Titan
1.
Genesis 1.
That's these two boxes here. This is a passive device, yeah? And we will go to the Genesis 1. This is an active power cleaner, so we're going to completely rebuild the mains sinus wave, completely new, with very low distortion. And the Titan 1 uses something called direct coupled design, which will give unbelievable power to the integrated here. I know we're on a time level, so I'll quickly allow this gentleman to select another piece of music. We'll play it on the Sigmas for you, and then we'll move on to the Genesis 1 and Titan 1. Genesis 1, and we'll be moving the integrated onto the Titan 1. And the cool thing about this is you can actually put 6 of them together, and it's a rack width component. You don't have to worry about 6 wall sockets because you can link them together and they will fully star earth as well, which is what we've done here. It's just so much more air, so much more space. We can actually hear into the recording. We can just fall over the multiple levels we're actually getting. The noise floors drop, the bass is a lot more articulate as well. It's just crazy, yeah? We probably upgraded this system by tens of thousands of euros quite easily. quite easily. And all we've done is change the input power. And these last two components, I mean, maximum cost, what, €3,500? How much is this being?
It's about 8,000 up.
8,000. How much is a lot?
The amplifier is roughly 10,000, ungefähr 10,000 der Verstärker und der CD-Spieler, ich meine, was, 5,5 oder sowas.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What else have we got here? Yeah. What are we? We're about maybe 10%? Maybe less? Yeah. Sounds a lot better now than it did to begin with. There's nothing wrong with this system. Absolutely nothing wrong with it. But you, my dear friends, yeah, you're probably listening to 80% of your investment. Yeah?
It is. Now so.
Think about it like this, though. You're wearing glasses, yeah? Nothing wrong with that. I have to wear glasses now. My arms got too short. If your glasses were dirty, yeah? You're looking at this, you get used to the world through dirty glasses, yeah? And I take your glasses off, and I go, hey. You go, Jesus Christ almighty, Jesus. It's so bright, it's so clear, there's so much more space. I haven't changed your eyes. I haven't changed your glasses. But I've allowed you to notice and see more what is already there. And that's what we're trying to do here. We're actually trying to take power from the wall. We're not trying, we're actually doing this. We're taking power from the wall, we're getting rid of all of this distortion, and we're allowing these audio components to really shine, to do what they're capable of doing. And we're getting rid of this kind of, this thing here. Yeah. And this is actually, this thing here, this is the greatest mystery in audio. Really is. There is nothing wrong with this cable if we know what it is, yeah? It is built and designed down to a price. It is not built and designed up to a quality, yeah? Please, if you have this in your system, get rid of it. Yeah? Put something else in. For €80 or less, you can buy an Initium, which is multi-award winning. It's 110 times better.
Aber es gibt drei gute Gründe, um übrigens so ein schwarzes Kabel trotzdem zu verwenden. Das erste ist für eine Kaffeemaschine. Das zweite ist für einen Wasserkocher. Und das dritte ist in so einer Demo. Aber ansonsten HiFi-Anlage, absolut nein.
Kaffee schon mal mit verschiedenen Kabeln.
Absolut. Wenn Sie unser Lila-Kabel, Extension-Kabel nehmen, dann schmeckt der Kaffee so ein bisschen blumiger.
Are you undoing all of my hard work? Okay, let's talk about the Genesis One. So what we've got is we've got a 400 watt Class D power amplifier. We're using a linear power supply, so we have very low distortion. We're taking alternating power from the wall socket, converting it back into DC using a very low distortion synchronous sine wave oscillation system, which surfs the incoming frequency of the main supply. We are rebuilding a brand new clean mains sine wave with very, very low total harmonic distortion. This is perfect for source components, CD players, DACs, preamps, etc. It will deliver 100 watts of continuous pure power, yeah? If you're on a little bit of a tight budget, I would recommend one for each product. I would do that. But if you're on a bit of a tight budget, you can buy one of these things, plug it in the back, and then you can use it for two outlets. Because this has a centralized filter system inside, both of these output sockets are completely independent and isolated from each other, and it works quite well. But please note, 100 watts continuous. This CD player will typically draw about 35 watts, so that's fine. So we could use a CD player and probably a preamp. If you have a valve preamp, for example, that has an inrush current of, say, 350, 400 watts, as the capacitors start to charge, this unit here is intelligent enough to go, moment, I will deliver you 100 watts, I'm not going to deliver you 350 watts. That would be really stupid. I would die. So what it does, it simply connects to the incoming mains momentarily, charges the capacitors, and then changes back to the full sine wave generating system. So you can use it with big tube amps without fear of it falling over.
Let's have a look at the display. We have total harmonic distortion coming in of around close to 2%, and this will fluctuate, and I would expect that because the mains varies. And we're outputting 0.25%. So that's almost, what, 10 times better?
I haven't tried this actually, but this would be a good experiment. I reckon if we turn off the CD player, we'll get a lower distortion figure there. Shall we?
You can. Can you? Okay, I will do it. Just wait a sec.
Maybe we have to turn it fully off?
No. It'll change.
Well, while that's thinking about it.
It's thinking about it. Will not.
There
it
is.
Zero five.
That's a lot better. Right, now what that's showing you is as wonderful as since 1925, as wonderful as they are, yeah, they're creating a lot of differential mode noises, it's drawing power. And the Genesis is fighting against it and doing a good job because it's giving it 10 times better power than it could have got from the wall socket. Yeah? So that just shows you that I wasn't really lying about the differential mode noise problem. Yeah? It is there all the time. The Titan One, we use a unique circuit in that we developed called direct couple design. It will basically hardwire the power amp to the incoming supply to give maximum better dynamic performance. So this is unique technology to IsoTek. Yeah? It's what we've developed. I will conclude this presentation now by giving you just a few words of thought to go away with. And I will be honest, I will steal the words of another gentleman. Yeah, a pioneer in audio, a guy who came from Scotland in England. Well, Scotland in Scotland, I suppose. We don't know what we're doing in England. We don't know where we want to be. We don't know if we want to be in, and we don't know if we want to be out. We just go round and round in circles. We don't know. This gentleman in Scotland, his name was Ivor Tiefenbrun. You probably know of him. He created Lin Audio. And in the 1970s, when they introduced the LP12 turntable to the market, most of the magazines and the general feeling in the audio industry was to focus in on the loudspeaker. Yeah? You'd be happy about that. So they're kind of really focusing on the loudspeaker in everything that they do. This was the big go-to point for an audio system, was the loudspeaker. And Ivor quite rightly said, he said, hey, look, guys, there's nothing wrong with what you're doing, but look, it's at the end. It's not at the beginning, it's at the end. We should start off with a really good source. Let's start off with a really great recording, play it on a great turntable, and of course, probably he would say that. Here's the LP12. Play it on a really good turntable because it can't magically get better down the chain. And I think we'd all pretty much agree with that, yeah? If you can go with an original pressing off original master tapes or high resolution music file off of the server, way better than an MP3, for example. But let's take that concept and take it one stage further. Yeah? The best turntable in the world, the best CD player in the world, or the best music server in the world won't work without power. Gone. But the quality of the power that you feed it will have a huge effect on its performance, as you just heard. So if we really want to start off at the source of a great sounding audio system, you need to do something about the power. And therein lies a wonderful opportunity for you. Because mostly when you buy a new piece of equipment, you get an improvement between one or two things. Let's go look at an interconnect cable. I can go easily and spend €10,000 on an interconnect cable, and I would get an improvement between two things, yeah? Which would then probably be held back by the lesser cable in the system. With something like an IsoTek, you will get a full system upgrade. We only use two components here. We could have plugged six things into the back of the Sigmas. You will protect and improve everything from the ground up, right from the get-go. That's really something you can't do with any other component in your audio line.
Und das gilt im Übrigen auch nicht nur für Audio, sondern genauso für Video. Also wenn man da jetzt einen Fernseher sozusagen, sondern einen Fernseher anschließt oder Projektor, man kann leider Gottes das Nachmittagsprogramm damit nicht verbessern, das können wir nicht. Aber die Bildqualität wird wirklich besser. Die meisten sagen, die es probiert haben, ist einfach Feedback. Man hat halt ein wirklich holographisches Bild, dreidimensionaler. Man sieht einfach tiefer in das Bild rein.
So, gentlemen, thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you also for your time. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for listening to the products. We've been given our wonderful system here, thanks to our partners ASCENDO and Luxman, and thank you as well. Enjoy the rest of the show. There's some great stuff for you to look in and see. Thanks again.
And we have some bags for you.
Oh, my gosh.